You already know what time it is. It's time for the Mo Show Awards. We're going to get this week started off the right way by giving away our first award of the week, and that is going to some amazing students in motion. Shout out to Julia and Kaden. You two are rock stars. You are amazing. Thank you for being such a big part of this week's challenge. If you aren't following us, go follow us right now at motion_WOLC. And to check out next week's challenge, go on Instagram and look. You don't want to miss it. Now, our second award is going to an amazing small group leader. That is Lily. Lily has so much energy. She's so fun to be around, and she's always excited to tell her students about the wonderful things that Christ has for them in their life. So Lily, we appreciate you. You are awesome, and thank you for being a big part of the Motion team. Now, our third award is for our Song of the Week, and that is You Get the Glory by Jonathan Traylor. This is an amazing worship song. Why? Because it reminds us that no matter what we're going through, God is always with us, and without a shadow of a doubt, we should always give him the glory, good, bad, indifferent, whatever. So make sure you go and listen to that song and share it with a friend. Hey, thank you so much for joining us once again on the Mo Show Awards. We'll see you next week.
6:30 a.m. Brandon, Mississippi. I am in middle school and I'm waiting for the bus to arrive so I can go to class. I can remember that as I'm waiting for the bus, I'm there with some friends, and the bus is arriving, and as my friends are getting on the bus, I remember one of them turned back to me and said, "Brian, I hate you." I don't know about you, but in that moment, I was hurt. I don't know if you've ever felt that way before, that words hurt you, that something that someone said, it affected you. See, what we know about words is that words are powerful. Like, we can use our words to build people up, or we can use our words to bring people down. See, what I've learned about words, and what I'm sure you have too, is that words can hurt, but also words can help. Like, have you ever had a message, a text message before, and it was some encouraging words and it helped you, it built you up? But in the same, maybe you've had a moment where someone said something to you that didn't help, but rather it brought you down. See, one of the things we know about words as well is that words, it's not just what we say, but it's also how we say it. Like, I can remember my mom, she would always tell me, "Brian, it's not just what you say, it's how you say it." Maybe some of you can relate to that. Words are powerful. And it brings me to the question of, okay, well, if words are powerful, then as a follower of Jesus, how can we make sure that we're using our words to help and not using our words to hurt? See, anytime that I have a question about how to be a follower of Jesus, I just go to the Word of God. I go to the Bible, because in the Bible, Jesus teaches us how to be a follower of him. And in the Bible, we see a passage of scripture in the book of Psalms in chapter 141 in verse number 3. I want to read it today. We see this moment where this guy named David, he does something. And I want to read what he does in Psalms 141, verse number 3. It says, "Set a guard, O Lord, over my mouth. Keep watch over the door of my lips, to keep me from speaking thoughtlessly." See, David had this moment where he realized that his words were powerful. And he wanted to make sure that he didn't just use his words just to use them, but rather he wanted to use his words intentionally. He wanted to use his words to help. He wanted to use his words to encourage. And what did David do? Well, he said, "God, I need your help. That he asked God in prayer to help him watch his words. And maybe for you, I would ask you this question. Do you watch your words? Like, if I was able to see all the texts you sent, if I was able to see all the comments you posted, if I was able to hear all the words you said to your friends, would they be words that were building up? Would they be words that were helping, or would they be words that hurt, that brought people down? See, this week, I want to challenge you that as a follower of Jesus, that we can use our words to help and not to hurt. And this week, I want to challenge you to do something. I want to challenge you first to pray a prayer that just says, God, can you help me to watch my words? Just like David prayed a prayer and said, God, can you help me to watch my words? God wants to help you watch your words. But not only that, the second thing I want you to do is I want you to use your words to encourage one person this week. See, the beauty of it is when you encourage someone, you are being the voice of Jesus in their life. And Jesus, he always has the right words of encouragement, the right words to help, and the right words for you in every moment of every day. So this week, let's watch our words, but let's also use our words to encourage others, to help them, but to allow them to see Jesus through us. Can I pray with you? Let's pray together. Father, thank you for today. God, help us this week to use our words to help and not to hurt. God, set a guard over our mouth so that we don't just say things without thinking before we speak, but rather, God, help us to think about the words that we're gonna say before we say them. Father, we know that you can help us to watch our words, so we thank you that you do it this week. God, we love you, and we pray it all in Jesus' name. Amen.